Nice, okay. Here we go. I know. Man, a couple of my losses have been turnover at the goal line. Oh, man. Yeah, that was a rivalry game right there, wasn't it? Nice deep kick there. Yeah, I know that play. It's in my bag of tricks. At least he didn't lose yardage. Just make this one succinct. Nice job there. All 11 guys on defense. Diagnosing the jet sweep and putting it down.
Just play number three here on the opening drive, and it's an early third and one. They'll try to run for the first.
Oh, nice. I didn't want to sell out on the run there. If you would have held on to it a second longer. Not what you wanted, huh?
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense
Yeah.
because he's had a good week of practice or something in the area. But they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game.
Oh, no! Oh. Flung him forward, too. Look at you, you got a decent tight end.
I can assure you this, Charles, it won't be the last.
No, it won't, because when he gets going, now it opens up opportunities on the perimeter, because
I turn
the defense towards him in the middle of the field. Now your wide receivers are getting involved as this game.
Ooh, excuse me. Fullback can kiss my ass.
You gotta cover him too. That makes things really difficult.
Oh, nice. All right. I'll give you that. Nice drive, nice drive. You like that, huh? We probably should. Oh, nice, nice hit stick. I got the headphones on. You know.
Yeah, I know that, but no. His headphones are going off. He scanned it a couple times.
Yeah, that's because she just ate. Give it about an hour, and then we'll check it again. Is what, you know. Nice. Oh, I know, huh? Oh no. Oh, okay.
Each team's had it, each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kicks away.
It did say it would be a track meet.
Certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in
first place in their division, looking really good and looking to be a threat come January.
You know, you want those early holiday shoppers, you want those guys get your list done, because I think about what every team has on their holiday shopping list right now. What's the number one goal? Make the playoffs. Number two, win your division. Number three, and I think the biggest goal of all, try to get the number one seed so you get that first round bye and ensure you don't have to go anywhere in January and hopefully get to the Super Bowl that way.
Oh, excuse me.
On first down, it'll set up a second and seven. It may be only a gain of 3 yards. That back, he deserves a lot more credit on the play. That could have easily been stopped at the line, but his vision and his determination found some space to turn it into that modest gain.
A throw over the middle, taken in. It's going to be another first down. There's a game of the Black Alliance 33. Down there at 21 yards. So the Lions in the Lion territory now. Here's first and 10. Down at the 33. Henry up the middle. Stops short of the 25. And that second effort got him a couple extra. Brought down. He's going to be dropped to the bottom. This will be a loss of three, and now a much tougher third down looming.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
On third down, he'll drop to throw.
Oh, that was in your hands. You schmuck. We all know he should have came up with that. Nice kick. He got it back to the 25. Yeah, it was.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. 3-5 is where they sit on the year. Very uneven start. It's certainly not an ideal position to be in at the halfway point of the season. And CD, do you see an avenue where they can still be a playoff team, or is that ship sailed?
Well, since you took me to the Nautica side, I'm going to try and keep up here, because to me, this ship is about ready to pull out of port. These next couple of games are absolute must wins for them. Now, if they can win a couple, get to 5-5.
Oh, no! Oh! This guy talking that crap.
So they just need 1 yard here to
two of those wins the computer just got me. Oh god. Woo! That was kind of weak.
In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Throwing on first down, but this all right. Is tough to be incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was.
Actually, we're trying to. You think?
Third down, they like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
They'll look to throw here. He gets this underneath to Dallas, and they'll get him down on the other side of midfield.
Well, was a busy man out of the backfield a week ago. They got the ball early and often. I had no doubt in my mind that he'll be a big part of the game plan here as well.
Woo! Oh, what the? Come on! What's the pump fake? Where'd he pump fake? Oh, come on. That was like pass interference like a mug. Right on his back and everything. Nice. Good job.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the word you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on the lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead a big way.
Oh, what the heck? You like that one.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that, because if they're forced to try and go around defenders behind the line of scrimmage, sometimes you can give yardage in order to gain it. But in this case, they gave yardage and didn't get it back.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to launch this.
What? Oh, come on. I did not switch. Oh. I did not switch dudes. That's all right. Over the 20-yard line. Come on now.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
weekend, but you think it's vitally important, Charles, that they focus on the task at hand here?
Absolutely, because these players, they know what's coming up, and the difference between taking time off following a win versus doing so on a three-game losing streak, that's absolutely huge, because they may come back if they lose this game to a facility, and there may be new faces in there and some teammates lost.
So give them 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and now 1 yard to go on third down.
That's a long one.
It's a quarterback sneak. And he's going to run into a brick wall right in the middle of the field. And I don't think he got there. They'll try and sneak it here. And I'm not sure he got there. Did they stop him? They did. So certainly an interesting call there. Here is the challenge flag is out, and we're going to get a review with that last
play. Oh, that's some bullshit.
So not successful there on the challenge, and he'll have to be careful from here on out because he'll only have one challenge remaining.
Oh, come on.
Touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And he returns this to the 22. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And they have the game here followed by the open date on their calendar next weekend. And Charles, this is a crew that you have to think really is relishing the opportunity to be on the couch for a few days.
Yeah, they certainly are, but let's face it, partner. They can't get caught looking ahead to that couch time while they're playing this one. They've got to take care of business first.
On first down, he'll drop to throw.
Oh, that was, come on, that's some bullshit. Block in the back right there. Oh, come on. The guy hit me from behind. Oh, these two need to get off your... Yeah. Get off the sack.
And you're exactly right. We're still in the first half.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
Yeah, and sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right back out. You're right back out on the field with a chance to return.
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. They'll set up a throw.
Oh, come on. You had the...
Sometimes it's just not your day. There's another film.
Yeah.
Second and 10. Back to throw here. Catch is made by Hockenson, the tight end. And
he will have they let him run right in the middle there. That's some BS. Oh, please. You've got to be joking. Oh, you... Can someone block?
The old football cliche that comes to my mind is you can't get it all back at once. They probably need something, though. At least 3 points.
Are you trying to say that there's no three-score drive on that play sheet for any offense coordinators? They just don't have it, right? You're trying to get it all back. You know you can't get it back in one drive.
Why are you trying to kill someone?
Desperate need of a conversion. as they come up on third down. They'll go again with Dobbins. Now this is only going to be a gain of two. He needed three. It's fourth and one. They're going for it with Dobbins. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. They've been burned twice already on fourth down, but the third time's the charm as they keep the drive moving.
We're all still valiantly searching for the so-called book, right, that tells us what to do in every situation. Everyone kind of knows what it says, but it's never really been written down anywhere. He violated every code on that one, didn't he? Decided to go for it right there.
Oh, yeah, your side of the field, this stage of the game, you're supposed to punt the football. He said, who cares? I'm going to light the book on fire.
Yeah, analytics, everyone else, be warned. He's coming for you.
And that'll be complete to Dobbins. Calling a gain of three on the play, and that's going to set up a tough third and nine.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it can turn into a big gain downfield. What a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
They'll set up to throw. Crossing route, and he's got his man. It's Renfrow. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So he turned to a trusted, familiar face in that third down situation. It paid off.
Yeah, you go to your veteran receiver in that spot, so you can't underestimate him when he's on the field. Defensively, make sure you know where he is because he understands how to get
the Vikings after it, and they get the set. The former third overall pick, Quinnen Williams, there to bring him down.
And that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football. Led to a sack. And that's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
He's got a man. That's Marshall. And they're going to get this up to midfield. And the Vikings are going to beef up their secondary here. Six DBs on third. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. That's complete. Again, he's got Marshall. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48.
I thought they might take a shot down the field, but instead they ran a little drag route there. I think they were hoping he could catch it and run away from the defender. But a really good job keeping the play in front of them, and they force a fourth down.
He'll drop to throw.
Come on! How the hell are you going to run around like that?
Lions trying to lay on fourth down. And this defense is going to get the football back near midfield, right at the 48. Here are the Vikings now.
That's some bullshit, and you know it.
They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. The defense was ready for the run-pass option, diagnosed it perfectly.
Not only did they stack him up at the point of attack, but he was met by a host of light-colored jerseys.
Throw left side complete. That's Cannon. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30.
This is just more of the same. This defense has had no answer on all of these throws. They let these receivers run wild. And here's another completion for good yardage.
They'll look to throw here on first down. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So,
it was out of bounds, dog.
Clearly unhappy with that call,
he was out of bounds. Don't. Oh, that's some bullshit. That's bullshit. I call bull to the shit. But you're going to challenge that too?
And now defensively, you have to look at this like the game's on the line. It's just a third quarter, but another touchdown given up here could really spell an end to their chances. So they need to toughen up and keep them out of the end zone.
They'll go with a keeper. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Officially no gain on the sneak. Kind of a wasted play there, and now it's third down. Now this time he'll look to throw. And it's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. A great effort.
This is some bullshit. Talking about bullshit.
Extra point by Carlson on the good. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. Offense ready to kick off their next drive. Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here, maybe beating the traffic, and even hoping to get home to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
They're talking shit.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty
good. I know. What's up with that?
That's what helped get them into this spot. And now they're continuing to trend with incompletions. But that won't get them out of it if they don't change something soon.
On second down, a run with Dobbins. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. 78 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. A couple extra tight ends in the formation here as they line up third and two. The slam connects with Devontae Adams. And he is going to have a Lions first down. And he's going to have it by
Clark.
Able to get 9 yards there on 32. Here's a give to Dobbins running right. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42. The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they officially confirmed that one.
And another old week, which we don't know nothing about yet.
It was like a weird monster-looking model thing. It looked like something from Extinction. It was really weird. It's quite seen in the future.
And they might just be moving the defense in a little bit. They could
that kind of relation action, maybe go over the not top. Impossible. Right now, because in the beta for Modern Warfare 3, people were able to access the calling cards.
Can you someone just block them? That's all I'm asking.
So people were able to access the calling cards in the beta, either you were supposed to. So that's how people were able to see what the camos look like, because there's camo calling cards. One of the weapons in the calling cards was the EM1 from Advanced Warfare. Yeah, the laser beam gun. Yeah, and apparently Season 3 is going to be Advanced Warfare. That's an old week set. That's next season. We're in Season 2 right now. I assume the Warhammer Club's gonna be very soon, because one of the upcoming weapons for the mid-season update is gonna be a sword. So I feel like they're gonna have also include the receivers.
I think this guy has a
connection. Usually when new weapons get released, they always you can either unlock it through a challenge, or you can just buy a version of it. And It would have been pretty good the other day if they had a Walking Dead. Because one of the things from Walking Dead.
Oh, I just got that in.
You know, shit.
I don't know.
Maybe she'll have to be sorry. No, they gave her like the gold kadachis, which is like the worst. It's the worst melee in the game. It's very slow compared to everything. Like, your mobility is not. Like, yeah, the sword has a range, but you don't have a knife running speed. But the issue is that they keep releasing the dual Kadachi blueprints. They're not. And they're adding, like, tracer effects or, like, custom objects. And they're not doing it with a knife! So I'm like, what the hell, man?
Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And this crowd is certainly liked what they've seen.
I should show you my latest video here. Because I started editing on my computer. Man.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
Also, I do not read your ex, willing for Sparkle. She's insane. She's better than Bronya, easily. Did you see the video I sent you? A few years ago?
Two things to watch. First is strength and being able to break out that initial contact. He still lost 4 yards. I don't want to hear
it.
Talking all this madness.
Task ahead of him here, needing a full 15 yards to move the chains. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Looks like a 9-yard loss. And it also brings up 4.
We've watched this a long time and I still don't believe we get it. Third and long, why are you calling play action?
Because they're not going to
play
trying to drain the clock, I see. Come on, that's some bull. Who else is watching this? Oh.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That good for 19 and a first down.
And then, did they hear this song?
Oh, they're going to run another pass here. And some nifty running here as he'll take this across midfield and down to the 47. 10 more there and another first down.
Oh, I even hit the hole there too.
It's so corny because a box just to carry a few kicks it and then a knife in it in the box. The knife in front of this game. I sent a picture to where him, dude. He's like,
"Oh, you gotta be joking."
It looks like America.
I want him hurt. We're putting a bounty out on him.
It's so funny. This game is turn-based because of April Fool's.
Now it says three watching.
Ten-19.
I hope you can't afford anyone when it comes time to re-sign people. Oh, please.
And then they did this for this guy. Like, now, like, he's free fighting too. There's, like, a bunch of memories and shit. Because it doesn't give, by the way, Kiri has cancer. Yeah. Bro's not doing good.
All right, good game. Wow, we still trying to run up the score, huh? Oh, I see how it is. You know what? Let's get your guy hurt. All right. See, when I say good game, that usually means I'm conceding the game. Right. Why do I... Oh, third down. The computer automatically did it. Like, why do I have an extra DB?
Victory formation time for the Vikings as they'll take a knee here.
Yes, 12 seconds. I can't do squat. Yeah. A couple stupid plays on my part. I'll admit. Yeah, it is. I'm telling you, Madden has it out for me. Won't even convert a fourth and one.
I didn't think it's that, but...
That's right, I said it.
Hey, you gotta send him to robot. You gotta send him to robot Vietnam.
Dude, like I said, right at the goal line too. Like, oh really? All right, finished game. Well, I got a bye week. Then I play Mike. All right, so.
Ruby getting shook with a dead man.
Advance.
It's a coffin.
Well, there's still a chance I can make the playoffs. That ship is sailing though. Yeah. I could have been 5-4. Those two losses. Totally like. Yeah, he's 4-3.
I just it's funny, like, just barging in the roof again. Who's killing you?
I still got a chance.
What happened?
It's a slim chance, but it's a chance.
My favorite duty character has...
Yeah, let me see what schedule.
Abraham Lincoln?
Let me see, I lost. Lost by 2 points to the Cowboys. I lost 1 point to the Panthers, 3 points to the Jets, and you really the only major blowout, the major losses I had was the blowout you did against me right now, and then the Commanders blew me out 49-10 in week 3. I lost to Mike in week 4 by a touchdown. Yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah. So, yeah, after the bye week, I get Mike, the Titans, the Giants, Sea Chickens, then I play you again. Yeah, Commanders kicked my ass.
At this point, they could AI generate the Ruby script, and no one can tell. It will still be shit.
That's a good question. Let's see. A few standings. Well, obviously...
Hey, guys, we have a new team member on the other team.
The NFC? The Cowboys are 6-1. Did they? How bad did they beat me? Let's see. Yeah. So I got a chance. Well, I don't want that. I want.
Guys.
Yeah, I lost to the Cowboys by 2 points.
You guys best behave, else I'll turn you.
That was in week 2. 2 points, yeah. Yeah. 26-24. Well, I'm supposed to go out to dinner with family, and we're meeting up around 4, I think. So
Dio's going to start having flashbacks of the flashbacks.
Yeah, so if we're starting at 5, like, come on now. Since when have we... Oh, regardless, 5 or 6, come on now. When have we ever started that early? Never. Exactly. So if it's like 8 or 9, okay, I can do that. But if it's like 5 or 6, nah, I can't do that. Yeah. That's why I said I could either do the Friday night or the Saturday, the Sunday. You know, those two. Yeah.
The whole thing was like, what's
that? Oh, well. We'll see what happens.
I'll
just show up after dinner.
That is my redemption.
You know. It's my aunts and uncles getting together, so we'll see. Yeah. All right, then. Good game. I take off for Chicago tomorrow, so we'll see when we... You know, how far along we can go.
Bro, I thought it was so stupid how she, like...
Yeah, probably next week.
...to live or whatever, and then Ruby eat the apple.
Yeah, so about Thursday is when I'll be back, I think. All right, we'll do. Take it easy. Talk to you later.